Hello and thank you for taking your time to watch this video. This is Prince Muafrica and in this video, I tell you how to succeed in life without matric or tertiary qualification. When you leave, you should have a plan of your life and attentively focus on it. Stick to the plan and never be distracted by anyone or anything. Have a finished plan of your life, you know, and pursue it. If you want to be a singer, work on becoming a singer. If you want to become a business person, work on becoming a business person. If you want to be a footballer, work on becoming a footballer. Or a rugby player, maybe work on it. If you want to be a successful politician, work on becoming a successful politician. That is how simple it is. If you want to become a videographer, makeup artist, or farmer, just work on it. All right, just work on it. There are many other things you can be or do for a living in life. There are so many things. Just make sure you are the best at what you are specializing in. Whatsoever you are doing, just make sure you are so damn good at it that people will not ignore you. Simple as that. Many of successful people are not successful because of they went to school. They don't have qualifications, many of them, and some don't even have matric. Just because people you spend time with have got different plans from yours, or they have got no plans at all, is none of your business. No one should tamper with your plan. Nothing should tamper with your plan. And one thing important is that you must never pick a fight you cannot win. Plan how you will win before you pick a fight. A plan is what we call finishing before you start. A plan is like a roadmap. It shows you a clear picture of the final destination, but also it shows you the best way to get to the destination. That is what we call a plan. That being said, let me be honest with you. Plans may change, usually because of uncontrollable circumstances or because of you have designed a small plan and later realized that it is not the size of plan you would be satisfied with. But it is better to change a plan than to not have a plan. You cannot have plan B if you did not have plan A. Even though a plan may change, the purpose should be permanent. Your purpose is your destination and your plan is your path to get there. You must have a plan and never give up on it until you achieve your dream. Life asks for a direction and destination from you. And if you don't answer it, it will answer for you. Your destination is created by you. You must have a plan for your life and stick to it. Planning, however, without action is futile. But without planning, action is fatal. Some people are crazy, you know. They have a mentality that things, you know, will just work out themselves, you know. They think things will just work out. They will never work out. As for me, Prince Muafrica, I do not believe in your so-called dream until you show me a plan. Actually, the wisest man wraps this matter of planning quite well and understandably so. He says in Proverbs 21, verse 5, good planning and hard work lead to prosperity, but hasty shortcuts lead to poverty. Eric Thomas says, whatever plan you have, do not think it will be easy to accomplish. And I tend to agree with him. The process is painful. Yes, it's hard, but it's worth it. Pain is temporary. It may last for a minute, a day, a month, or a year, but eventually it will subside. At the end of pain is success. But Napoleon Hill, in his book titled Think and Grow Rich, he says if you give up before your goal has been reached, you are a quitter. He says a quitter never wins and a winner never quits. Some people have plans in their minds, but they never want to implement them. They just keep on procrastination. They keep on, procrastination. Just do it and stop wasting time. Bruce Lee, this guy, he is a martial art, but then he wants to be a motivational speaker. He says, if you want to learn to swim, if you want to learn to swim, you've got to jump into the water, because you can't learn to swim outside water. I agree with the Kung Fu boy. How can you learn to swim if you are outside the water? It's quite not possible. You've got to go into the water. I don't want to sound too talkative or philosophical, but please allow me to confirm that the few people who say future is predictable, they are right. They are right. I think they are really right. Future is predictable. Peter Drucker says the best way to predict the future is to create it. When you create it, you are able to predict it. I like what Estee Lauder says. He says, I never dreamt about success. I worked for it, But Miles Monroe, may his intelligence usher all over the world. He says people fall into three groups. The few who make things happen, the many who watch things happening, and the overwhelming majority who have got no idea of what is happening. The question is, which group do you fall into between the three people I've just talked about? There are many things you can choose to do, on earth. Many things. You just have to choose and, grow towards that particular thing you have chosen. The process that you will be going through while you are chasing whatever you chose is called personal growth. You must grow towards something, and you choose what you want to grow towards. All right. That is how simple it is. If you don't build your dreams, someone will hire you to build theirs. Lastly, please don't forget to subscribe and hit on the bell to get notified every time I upload a new video. Get ready for my new videos, guys, because they are going to be hot. I'm going to make sure they are meaningful to your life and they really become vital in a sense that they make you a better person. And I thank you so much, guys.